मस्त बिटिया, सदा खुश रहो। आई एम डॉक्टर हेमंत व्यास, एमडी होम्योपैथी, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर एंड हेड ऑफ डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ सर्जरी, फैकल्टी ऑफ होम्योपैथिक साइंस, ज्योति विद्यापीठ, वुमेंस यूनिवर्सिटी, जयपुर। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट एन इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक, दैट इज लिम्फोडीमा। लिम्फोडीमा मे बी डिफाइंड एज एबनॉर्मल लिम्ब स्वेलिंग कॉज बाय accumulation of increased amount of high protein interstitial fluid secondary to defective lymphatic drainage in the presence of normal net capillary filtration. What are the risk factors? Upper limb or trunk lymphedema. The risk factors are surgery for lymph node dissections, that is breast surgery, radiotherapy to breast or to axillary or subclavian lymph nodes, subclavicular lymph nodes, wound complications, cancer, obesity, hypertension, chronic skin disorder, air travel and congenital predispositions. Lower limb lymphedema include obesity, varicose vein stripping, advanced cancer, orthopedic surgery, surgery with inguinal lymph node dissection, then post-operative pelvic radiotherapy, genetic predisposition, family history of chronic edema, thrombophlebitis and chronic venous insufficiency. The symptoms and signs include constant dull aching pain, even severe pain can be noted, burning and bursting sensation, general tiredness and debility, sensitivity to heat, pins and needles, cramp sensation, skin problems including flakiness, weeping, excoriation and breakdown, immobility leading to obesity and muscle wasting, backache and joint problems, athlete's foot, acute infective episodes, toes become square shaped and Stamer's sign is positive. Now what is Stamer's sign? If we are not able to pinch the skin over first toe, then we call it as Stamer's sign. Classification: primary lymphedema, in which the cause is unknown or at least uncertain and unproven. It is thought to be caused by congenital lymphatic dysplasia. Secondary or acquired lymphedema, in which there is a clear underlying cause. Primary lymphedema, all cases of primary lymphedema are due to an inherited abnormality of the lymphatic system, sometimes termed congenital lymphatic dysplasia. Primary lymphedema is much more common in the legs than the arms. Classification: congenital onset is more than 2 years old, sporadic, familial, Noni-Milroy's disease. So congenital lymphedema is called as Milroy's disease. Precox, sporadic, familial is called as Maggie's disease and lymphedema trada. Secondary lymphedema, this is the most common form of lymphedema. There are several well-recognized causes including infection, inflammation, neoplasia and trauma. You can see the difference between both limbs. This is generally the lymphedema caused due to filaria. Investigation of lymphedema: routine test, lymphangiography, isotope, lymphoscintigraphy, computerized tomography, magnetic resonance imaging, ultrasound and pathological examinations. Management: relief of pain, control of swelling, decongestant lymphedema therapy, intensive phase skin care, manual lymphatic drainage, multilayer lymphedema bandaging and compression garments, excessive exercise, maintenance phase, surgery. Only a small minority of patients with lymphedema benefit from surgery. Operations fall into two categories, that is bypass procedure and limb reduction procedures. Bypass procedures include the rare patient with proximal ileoinguinal lymphatic obstruction and normal distal lymphatic channels might benefit, at least in theory, from lymphatic bypass. Limb reduction procedures include Sistrunk, Homans, Thompson and Charles procedures. That's it from the today's presentation. This session is powered by Digital Version 2.0, Jyoti Vidyapeeth, Women's University. Hope you are satisfied with this digital session. If you have any query, please mention in comment box. I will try to resolve it. Thank you very much.